Hello everybody, it's Not Too Old Gamer, back with another Minecraft Let's Play. Been working in farming sim a little bit and wanted to come back and do a little bit over in Minecraft. Worked on a little bit without recording, trying to set up a little bit of farming, get some food under control. Got some wheat going on. I don't have any carrots or anything yet. But and maybe I'll find some eventually. But also built these neat little areas to keep the cows and chickens under control. And then some are getting out anyway, so that might not have been terribly effective. But I do like having a little place that I can hop in and oh, there's a pig. that's not great. Little place that I can go and pick up eggs and such. If I want some chickens, I can come in here and take care of that. And it's always fun to see if I can hatch some baby chicks. Hopefully, won't throw anything at them. There we go. Whoa! That guy wouldn't. There we go. Wow, I'm getting a lot of them. That's kind of cool. Got two or three in that little bit, but I think I want a chicken dinner. So let's take care of that. I did notice kind of have to want a pork chop too. Kind of have to have a little two-door system here, otherwise the chickens get out really easily. I haven't done that for the cows yet. They're over here. Probably need to make them a little bit bigger pasture, but for right now they seem okay. Yeah, this is why I need a second door, because they're kind of blocking me in. There we go. I can always get up to the top if I'd like to. To check them out over there. Hey, Mr. Cow. Don't come out this way. Hang out in there with your buddies. I'll bring back some food in a minute. But, let's head over and cook some of this for when I get hungry later. Made myself some windows so I can see what's going on outside. Already got some pork chops. Probably one of the first things I want to do is make a hopper for that once I decide to automate that. I've got some shears here. I'm trying to remember what all is in this world. I've been playing with Feed the Beast a little bit, doing some agrarian skies. That's kind of fun. So, hadn't been spending as much time over in this one, but it's all fun. Let's put that pork chop up there. Now let's mine a little bit. So the mine, I've been kind of quarrying out all the different types of blocks. You can kind of here, there's. Whoa! That's not good. My finger came off the shift button. And that was not great. But you can see in here, there's a great big chasm here that I'm trying to build this column down. I used some gravel to kind of create the edges all the way down, and then I'm trying to go back and fill it in with something a little more solid. So we'll take a look at what that is looking like here. So you can see right here, right, this is my column, You can see I've got gravel kind of going down to the bottom, and then I've been trying to build a framework of cobblestone to give myself something solid. Ooh, there we go. So what I've been doing, let's see, I'm going to need a crafting table real quick to... there we go. Let's see, I need to make a ladder just to demonstrate what I've been doing. Oh, kind of blind too. There were ladders right there. Thought I had an axe. There's my axe. So, as I go down, you can see, right, I've got gravel all the way down. And since that's gravel, I know there's something under it. I can dig straight through. Also, I dropped all this gravel, so I know that it goes all the way to the bottom. Now, with that in place, I can come over here. I can't quite see to place the block from there. So, come down another level. I'm holding down shift so I don't fall. And I should be able to come out and make a solid area here. Right, so now it's solid, and I can build that the rest of the way down. So just keep doing that, heading down and filling in the walls as we go. So I need to go back up. There's gravel. I need to go mine some just get some cobblestone. Do I have a... maybe I should just make a cobblestone generator. Once I get that all the way down, I'll probably put a water block at the bottom so I can just jump. That tends to be a little bit safer getting down. But for the meantime, while it's raining, let's keep excavating. So you can tell I've been just kind of excavating some rooms back in here, excavating out different kinds of stone, and dug it all the way through to have a back door out here. All right, there we go. Let's go make another pickaxe. I will need a few more sticks. Oh, I already have some pickaxes. Great. Kind of missing Tinker's Construct from playing in Feed the Beast. I might have to switch that over. That's kind of a fun pack. Good mod to play with. All I'm doing in here, I don't really have any specific plans for this room. Just hollowing it out, thinking eventually I want to build something that will require a big room. Probably, I don't know. Maybe a indoor farm or something, but it'll also give me some decent cobblestone for that. least a stack before I head back down. This way, at least I can see it. We should have, yeah, I've got a stack in a little bit. Alright, let's have some chicken and head downstairs. Got enough, yeah, my tools are okay to head down. Alright. So, I know there's gravel here. Let's fill this in. And eventually I'll probably want to come down and actually mine that area out. But right now all I'm trying to do is get down to the bottom so that I can make my mine. Pretty sure, yeah. This is my, when I'm going open again. I have to kind of be careful that there's no skeletons or anything hanging out, just ready to pop arrows in you. There's some chickens down there. Let's reach down, see if I can place some blocks down there. There we go. Give me a little bit of safety if I manage to fall. I hope I won't. This is where I need to have the ladder come down. It's pretty important when you are doing this to make sure you don't run out of ladder. Keep doing this. It gets a little boring, but the alternative is falling to your death in the mine, and let's not do that. That's no fun. It's almost as irritating as getting blown up by a creeper in episode 1. Oh wait, I did that. Alright, let's dig some more. See, I've still got plenty of ladders, I've still got else, so let's dig. Oh, look, a creeper, two creepers. Let's not go down there. another useful tip. It's important to have lights. You don't want to be too dark either. I think as soon as I get this next cobblestone section going. I will be setting up lights. Ah, and I ran out of cobblestone. Yay. There we go. I know I brought some torches down here. So that one right there, I'm not going to leave it inset or sitting out. I want it to be outset like that so that when I do set the water block in the bottom to drop, so I can drop down the shaft, that it will not stop me and hurt me on the way down. So I need some more cobblestone before I can finish this, but if we look, we're down to Y25. I want to get down to about Y16 to start mining. So a little bit further to go. Back to the top. I suppose I could mine out one of the other levels, but the surface is okay. And we'll do another couple of stacks to try to let us finish this off. Definitely want to replace that torch that I just knocked down. I don't want it getting too dark in here. There's nothing quite like sitting in your base, being away from your keyboard, and all of a sudden something interesting spawns, and all of a sudden you come back and you've got a respawn message. I don't like that. That's not fun. I should go down there and get those. Make another stone one. We'll drop down here and pick those up real quick. Almost a whole stack. I think that was a pig that just walked by the door, but I kind of want to go see. Just to be sure. Yeah, I think it was this pig. I just saw something walk by and I was like, I wonder what that was. Got almost 2 stacks, so let's head down. Not have enough materials to finish building walls last time. I used a lot of gravel getting down here, if that was not obvious. Go down some more. Basically using this like an elevator at this point. Let's see, I'm gonna get one more down. Uh-oh. Something bad just happened. I'm going to seal myself in here real quick. Yeah, I got hit by a skeleton. So I mentioned that. You gotta be careful. I was not following my advice, and I'm really glad that I was not higher up, because that would have been another kind of awkward way to end an episode. So, yay. That was fun. Alright, so if I can complete that, that's the right line. Hopefully, Hopefully I've got enough ladders to get back. Ooh, not quite. Well, that's unfortunate. There's... okay. I do have some arrows. I don't really know where that skeleton is. Don't see him in there. Oh well. What I really need at this point is a place to drop a crafting table so that I can make a let's see if I can just jump it. Yeah, there we go. Alright. I'm gonna get out of here. I only need one more ladder. There we go. So I just took it from the bottom. I'm gonna go, come back to the top, make some more ladders, and then, finish up this column so that I can get down to the mine. That was a little more dangerous than I had actually wanted it to be. Oh well. Ladder pattern. Let's see how many I can make. And we'll keep 4 sticks to make tools. Whatever tools I can think of. All right. Whoa. Clearly I'm just not doing that good a job with not falling and hurting myself at this point. But anyway, now that I have a reasonable ladder all the way down, I should be able to relatively safely dig some of this out. And expand this column a little bit. Alright, let's dig some more. So we're at Y14, which is actually a pretty decent place to start mining, but I don't really want to start mining in a big open chasm like this. That was not exactly as planned, but we'll persevere. Let's Let's see. If I go this way, I should be able, I should get out of that area. So let's, I'm going to need to stabilize this wall a little bit. I don't want all this gravel. There's a lot of redstone in there. I'm going to not deal with that right now. There's a creeper. I definitely don't want him coming over to play. There's that skeleton. That's the one that was bugging me. So this is going to be a little twitchy because I know he's there. And when I open this up, he's going to have an excellent opportunity to put some arrows in me. And I'm sure he would really enjoy that. But I don't want him to do that. I don't think that would be fun. I can think of several other things that I would rather do. Shoot him full of arrows might be one possibility. No, I don't want to use a stone. Oh, wow. Don't want that to be right there. I kind of want that block right there. And right there. There we go. And you'll notice I'm not standing on the redstone block that I was mining. I was actually standing away from it. That's important. Alright, so down here, now let's, if I was counting correctly, oh great, this is not actually going into the wall. There's a, I was thinking that I was close to the wall of the chasm, so I could go just right into a mining tunnel from there. But I wasn't. So let's kind of look around, see what's around us. Oh, that's fun. Alright, so if I dig over that way, I'll be at a tunnel, at a wall pretty soon. Side. Making myself a little, little room here down at the bottom just to have a little bit of space. It's not quite what I wanted when I started this mine, honestly. But, oh well. Wow, I really need to put that block back. Oh, always be ready, right? Always have a block ready to ready to replace one if you need to. Goodness. That was significantly closer than I really wanted to be to a skeleton. I think I'll just leave that two blocks high for right now. That'll be fine. Now on this side, I think there's water right there, but if I can place it correctly. Whoa, that's not what I wanted. Trying to put one right there. Yep, there we go. And that way, I can build the build kind of a longer or a wider tunnel that heads into the wall if I have accurately figured out where the wall is, which I hope I have. I normally would like to make this three tall, but as we've already established, yeah, that skeleton's still hanging out. Yep, there he went. I'm just really carefully trying to make it so I have a three block tall area down here. And I'll eventually, hopefully, yeah, now I'm getting into the actual wall of the chasm. There we go. So this will let me build a kind of 3x3 tunnel as my main backbone of the mine. Why 3x3, not 2x3? I don't know. It seemed reasonable, or seems reasonable. I will need to pop that away and that away. Hope the skeleton doesn't come over. And there we go. Now, I don't really like having that open, so I'm going, since I've got the space down here, I'll do that. Now for my landing spot, since I know I'll be, well, hopefully, landing right there. Let's do that. And that way, if I've done this correctly, I should be able to just pop right off and end up dropping safely. That's ideal. Alright, so now I've got a little room down here, and I can build out a couple things that I need for a base. A little small base down here. Hopefully for some good mining. I'll need a furnace. I've got a crafting table. I'll need a furnace to be added to it. Whoa. Well, that's interesting. Got some lava right there. Have to be careful. I definitely do not want too much of that. So I'll just place the, it's a decent spot for the furnace. And, yep, that'll be a decent spot for the crafting table. That'll be nice. Alright, now I want to dig this way a little ways, just to make sure I'm good in that wall. And then I'm going to start doing a pretty basic mine. It's important down here to keep everything lit. You definitely, I don't know, for some reason I just like for them to be symmetrical. But you definitely want to keep things lit, because you do not want to come down here and find zombies or creepers or skeletons spawning inside your mine. That's not fun. I'm going to block that up a little bit. The only reason I'm blocking that up like that is because I want to dig out that the rest of that iron ore. And some people like to fill in as they go, you know, to keep their walls nice and straight. Some people don't. I think it depends on kind of where you are and what your intent is, which way you tend to end up. For right now, in this main hallway, I'm going to keep everything. Going to try to keep it relatively straight and clean, but as we branch out the mine, I might not. Let's build some chests real quick. Two chests, and then obviously, I can't put them in the wall like that, but what I can do is come right here. I don't really need three, but what I'm doing is making space for a double chest kind of right in the middle. And then I can add the diorite, andesite, gravel. I'll keep part of a stack of cobble on me, and eventually I'll find some coal so that I can smelt some of that into iron ingots. Anyway, this is going to take a little while, and at least we've got a good start going to the mine. I'll probably cover mining more in the next episode, and until then.